Sophia to serve, love all.
One, love.
Bottle challenge, immediately putting Adriana a step behind the table. You'll see this with right-handers versus left-handers a lot. Long curving serves into the backhand. Little help off the net here to set up the forehand finisher. Diaz very rarely letting an opportunity go to waste. Quickly taking control. Diaz on the chase to the corners. In just a moment when the ball's in play, and she's able to bring it back in. Good balance. This is something that, for me, her balance and speed has improved a lot.
Two all.
Aggressive Chiquita attempted here, the banana flick. Chiquita actually, well, nicknamed by Japan in the native language of Adriana Diaz, Spanish, Espanol.
Two, three.
Now this shot right here is a bit unusual. It's one of the specialties from Adriana. The backhand punch, she does it at a slower pace here relative to her. She can finish points with that, but that was about an 80% shot with less rotation.
Three, all.
First towel break, dead even, nothing between them. Remember, head to head, I'll get you the specifics, but it was Adriana Diaz who won their last and only encounter. Well handled on the receive, Polkanova. That wide forehand tested. Clever play. Diaz shortening it way up after sending Polkanova to the backhand side deep. Soft touch shot the other way, the in and out game.
Five, four.
Handcuffing serve, gets a passive receive from near the baseline. Diaz clearly looking for different options moving forward.
Five, four.
This is a very unusual point. Again, by physicality, you wouldn't guess that it would be Polkanova on top of the bounce time and time again. Diaz on the chase, but she's got some wingspan. Adriana Diaz, by comparison, the shorter of the two, but way taller than average for the women internationally.
Six, five.
And as mentioned before, just getting faster and faster. Only 23 years for Adriana Diaz of life so far. Extra spin.
5-7.
You've probably seen videos of Adriana Diaz. They even have a poster of her here spinning the racket on her fingertips, which she'll sometimes do between points. She's got incredible feeling, touch, control.
Six,
clever serve.
Seven.
Fast and long to the backhand once again. The Austrian superstar within 1 point.
Eight, six.
Heavy rotation there. The push from Adriana Diaz able to generate a lot of spin.
Eight, six. Left.
There was a silent service warning. We've got one umpire
eight,
mic'd up.
Six.
Assistant umpire telling Adriana Diaz she needs to adjust her serve.
Eight, seven.
We have seen a fair share of service faults called today. Could be an evaluation period for the umpires.
7-9.
Again, a very comfortable but felt like 80% shot here for Adriana Diaz. The backhand punch has brought tears to Chinese opponents over the years. Tough to find others who can do that shot to practice with. There it is again.
7-10.
And it sets up three game points, playing it out to the forehand side. Not only is it fast and is it a lower trajectory, but there's less rotation, so the ball doesn't lift when it comes off your racket. 7-10.
Let. 7-10.
Quality spin from Polkanova as she turns the corner. A little bit of dissatisfaction on the other side. Sometimes it's just about shot selection. A little bit flatter there. Adriana Diaz and Truls Morgaard share this quality. Creativity and ability to flat hit in the open rally. Two game points left for Adriana Diaz. Backhand
11.
Does it, 11-8, and the world number nine takes game number one. Up-and-coming star for Singapore, but back in the women's action, it's Adriana Diaz with a fast, long serve to the baseline to start it off, continuing the momentum from last game. And a dribbler off the top of the net. Bit of apology there to acknowledge the fortune, as this ball would have been more playable had it not touched the net. And it wasn't intentional. All part of the game, though, tends to balance out.
2-1.
So long serves. Polkanova starting off here with quite a high percentage. And long serve once again, pinning the backhand. Until Adriana Diaz shows that she can punish Polkanova for these serves, Sofia's going to keep going for it. And a taste of her own medicine, but she seems to like the taste well handled on the backhand. Sofia swiftly sends it back. One serving four for Diaz. A nice length on the push, leaving the back edge of the table as an obstacle. It's tough to imagine how clever and creative some of these shots are, but they're constantly playing with space. Not just spin, not just power or speed, but using the table as an obstacle.
5-2.
And a long push to the backhand, surprise quality push there. Fast and low from Diaz. Well driven back, a secure shot going to the length of the table. Cross court, a bit more to work with in terms of margin for error, but right into the armpit, the perfect shot.
4-5.
1 point game now. From what, 1-4 down?
6.
But a much needed point here. Polkanova with the heavy spin from a step behind the table. Long push to get into the rally, barely even a step, just turns, pretty much holds her ground, sets up in a comfortable spot there.
6-5.
1 point game once again. Sofia cleans the racket for the pendulum serve. Handcuffing right near that edge of the table. It's tough because if you swing, you're in danger of hitting your racket and or your hand. They call it a finger breaker. Comes clear by a bit, but from that camera angle, you could only see the side, the baseline of the table, tough to reach around. And at the towel break here, I'd like to tell you the last time they played was 6 years ago.
6-7.
Maybe 5.5. Either way, Adriana Diaz would have been 17 or 18
six,
at the most.
7.
Still able to beat the now 29-year-old. Would have been 23, 24 possibly. Smart placement right at that elbow. Talked about it a lot yesterday with some taller players on the table. But taller players have a bigger crossover section between the forehand and the backhand, a bigger target to hit there in the middle. Six of the last eight for Adriana Diaz, some serious momentum.
Let. Seven all. Seven,
well
eight.
Handled receive. The reverse pendulum coming out for the first time in quite some time. A taller left-handed player would have a lot of ingredients to do that serve well. Matti Ekholm, an expert of that serve. Slightly taller left-handed player.
Eight. All.
But a tighter serve here. The backspin to make it bite and keep it close to the net. Diaz level with the serves back.
Eight, nine.
Again, surprising push here. Moving it around well, Polkanova. Just keeping cool. It is a little toasty, nothing uncomfortable here.
Nine all.
Third towel break. And if you've never been to Singapore, I can't recommend it highly enough, but especially during this week of action. The 17th is the last day of the Singapore Smash in its very third edition, and we've got another Smash to follow in early May in Saudi Arabia. Aggressive
9-10.
From the baseline, Diaz sets up game point. They've been neck and neck and toe to toe. And here they are face to face with one more serve for Polkanova. And she's got the response. Diaz brings the heat. Sophia counters back quickly, and here we are at deuce in game number two. Forehand power, short side on the counter, alternating serves until one player has a two-point lead. Diaz with a bit of spin, the ball
11,
won't come
10.
Down. Polkanova following, though, just in case. It's always an awkward ball when it comes off the edge of the racket. A shot like this could carry forward. Game point, Polkanova. Little help
11,
off the top of the
all.
Net. But an apology from Adriana Diaz. Deuce once again. Creative shot nonetheless, near the hip. Diaz just guiding it forward with a little bit of topspin, but not a full stroke forehand. Nice change of timing here, a little more shallow on the table. Sophia changing it up. She's got a game point once again. Watch the bounce. That one, a good foot inside the baseline. So interesting to me how effective this backhand has been. Adriana Diaz not even bringing out the full power punch, the bullet backhands. But still, even 80% of the speed she's capable of is fast, it is flat, and it is tough to rally with. Out of the fourth towel break, third deuce point. Taking the legs out, smart placement, pinning that backhand corner once again, and Sofia Polkanova with another game point. Adriana Diaz is going to be looking to get closer to the table where she can. Ooh, and a gift.
Certain all.
Interesting. It's a rare occasion that you see a player win a point and have a timeout.
Yes.
Adriana Diaz has a whole list of serves that are tricky to receive. Here's one of them.
14, 13.
Shovel serve, half long, but appeared to be side and topspin. And now game point for Adriana Diaz once again. And continuing this marathon game, Sofia Polkanova, 14 all. deuce once again. What a response. The power 15, comes 14. In. Polkanova with the racket high has deflected so many of these power opening forehand shots. Keeping that racket high, crucial game point once again for the Austrian superstar. But Diaz 15, keeps all. It alive, and we've got ourselves a fifth towel break should the players want it. Sixth deuce point between these two. Seen some long games here. Remember, games are to 11, must win by two. This is 16, incredible. 15? The chase, there's no shortage of wingspan on Sofia Polkanova's side. But she's really being run around and comes right back in quickly. Wide stance, quick turns. Diaz on the chase, game point, Polkanova.
16 all.
Tug of war. Neither will lie down. Imagine this is only game two of the match. Even the fans feeling the heat. Quality opening, 16. A little bit of room at the back of the table. Stealing the opening attack. Game point once again. What a save from Polkanova. But Diaz is able to put it away after the net ball sets her up with a good point. Coach Zhang there encouraging Polkanova.
Yes. 17 all.
Basically saying, keep it up. Break against you, yes, but you got it. Backhand serve now.
Net. Stop. Warning. 17 all.
Well, I imagine the assistant umpire elaborated. Quality 17, rally, and it's game point for Adriana Diaz. Would love to know what the warning was on that serve. Could have been height of toss. Backhand serves tend to have a little bit lower tosses if you're not Sahyeowon, who had a big win earlier today. The veteran chopper for Korea, but it's game point for Adriana Diaz once again. That's the backhand that I know, but it's not an easy shot. And with a low spinny shot coming in, it's Sofia Polkanova who's able to take it. It's tempting. Diaz can do that shot. And when she makes it, it rarely comes back. 18 all. Well played from deep 18. In the backhand court to short on the forehand side, moving back into the table. Polkanova once again in position.
19-18.
Quick movement early, the fast feet and the big steps. Game point, Polkanova.
Yeah!
And she takes second it 20-18. Leveled out now, one each.
One love.
Perfect technique there on that forehand, as clean as can be, putting the pressure on with the third ball, Polkanova.
Love two.
Now that camera angle right there is the perfect angle to really appreciate how far behind the table Diaz is pushed. In terms of momentum, six of the last 8 points for Polkanova.
Love three. Three, one. 4-1.
Somehow, Polkanova manages to find the middle, the crossover of Adriana Diaz, even when she's behind the table here. Watch. Right there into the middle, forcing Diaz to twist and turn sideways to create the forehand space. Little help off the edge here, but a much needed point as Diaz comes into the first towel break. Just 2 points down now. Nearly 6 years since their last encounter, and while they both improved, you would imagine that Adriana Diaz, by world ranking and everything else, is the more improved of the two.
3-4.
Sofia Polkanova has been in the top world rankings for some time now, inside the top 30 for about as long as I can remember.
4-4.
Even up to just outside the top 10. I think we've all had that experience when you've been at a restaurant that has a menu that's too big, so you can't decide, too many options. Adriana Diaz's menu of shots, she has so many shots on her menu to choose from. And from time to time, you'll see a little hesitation because she knows she can do a lot of things. Kick serve here, right to the backhand. And a 2-point lead for Austria's Sofia Polkanova.
5-6.
But a heavy spin shot reaches the edge of the racket on the opponent's side as Adriana Diaz brings it back within one. The touch game that sets it up, taking a little bit of rotation off it in the push.
6-4.
Second towel break, and they're level once again. We've seen a lot of level score lines in the last game alone. Beautiful opening backhand on the parallel. Polkanova.
7-all.
Again, it amazes me. From the start of the match, I mentioned how unusual it is that Sofia manages to stay so close to the table, the timing that she has. Again, as a taller player, it takes longer to recover normally.
8,
but compact
7.
Strokes on both sides, and in this rally, Adriana Diaz with a fuller stroke from behind the table takes the point. Good placement there, deep to that forehand corner once again, changing up the pattern.
7-9.
Business end of game number 3. And both of these players would love for it to end before 2018. That said, Adriana Diaz much closer to that right now. Kill
8,
shot inside
9.
The baseline, over the table, prowess from Polkanova. Reverse pendulum. Not especially high, but high enough. 10, point here
8.
Sets up 2 game points. The touch play, Adriana Diaz with the soft hands. 6 of the last 8 points for Adriana Diaz as she pats her chest there. Not the type of body language you hope to see. Playing in humid areas sometimes can be a little bit tougher to breathe.
10,
on the move
9.
Once again. It's Polkanova with that wide shot off the bounce. Forehand to the middle.
10,
quick decision.
9.
Was starting to look for forehand and played the backhand wide. And
10,
we've got another
4.
Deuce, just in case we didn't get enough in the last game. These two stand toe-to-toe once again. I did talk to Adriana a little bit yesterday, had a bit of a sore throat. Could be affecting things. That said, they've both played through their fair share of all sorts of conditions. When you're a table tennis player, you're constantly traveling the globe. I don't know any other sport that involves this much traveling. Game point, third time this game for Adriana Diaz. And what appeared to be the setup she wanted had heavy spin on it. Sofia Polkanova is really able to generate incredible variety in her game. The rotation on that ball, clever play from the Austrian.
12-11.
Impressive receive. The serve was fast, long, and had caused trouble before. It had been very effective for Polkanova. But 12, Diaz keeps 11. The racket high and earns herself a fourth game point. There it is, the forehand. The apology just after. Singapore smash, only bringing the best.
One love.
Can't ask for much higher quality than this. Counter loop exchange, both players active a step behind the table. Diaz floating around.
One all.
The precision in the placement from Polkanova. Watch this, right to the elbow. A little bit more to the backhand, but still not wide to the backhand.
Stop warning. Not vertical.
There we go. I love it. Not vertical. I don't love the service warning. I love the clarity to know what it is. Polkanova checking, saying, was it back towards my body or away from the table? What specifically? Where was it not vertical? The Diaz backhand bomba, the
one,
punch.
Two.
Bullet backhand from up a little higher. Not easy to play. Jorgen Persson, who's here as a coach, one of few. His was more of a swat.
Oh.
A nice net recovery here from Polkanova. The finisher. I was concerned for a minute that something happened to the knee. Polkanova with an unusual step for a moment. Holds still and slides. Everything seems to be fine.
Let 2-3. One. 4-2.
The amount of pressure on the body in these points is really incredible. Even young players like Yukiya Uda, who had been quite starring at the Singapore Smash, is taken out early due to injury.
Five, two.
Just pinpointing the placement here. Polkanova. Hope Adriana's feeling fine. Seen her pat her chest a few times. A bit more defense in this rally as Diaz stays behind the table. No lobbing, nothing too funky. Side and topspin, still quality shots, but the pressure from Polkanova sets her up with a 6-2 lead.
2-7.
Well, the way this is looking right now, still a ways to go. We've seen bigger comebacks, but Sofia Polkanova looking for that decider, game number 5.
8-2.
Austrian on a roll right now, serves back with her.
Nine,
little help
two.
Up the top of the net, but I think she had a few in the bank, a few IOUs left from earlier on. You might recall the net that she recovered in that high deuce game number 2. Then the end of game number three as well.
2-10.
And a perfectly half-long serve sets up 8 game points for Austria's Sofia Polkanova. The most 11, dominant 2, game 14, we've seen yet. In fine form now, the European, to see who will move on to the round of 16. Well, neither player making it easy for the other. It's Polkanova with the momentum still after a dominant game number four. Racket high in the middle, forehand to the short side for the finish. 12 of the last 16 points for Sofia Polkanova. And completely misleading here, creating the opening. A tennis tactic, hitting it behind the body's momentum. Coach Cho Jianxin on the bench for the currently based in Japan, Adriana Diaz. Perfect placement on the serve, a much needed point early in this game. Adriana Diaz has more swag than almost anyone I've seen in the game. More flair, more flash. And this is some of it, that little bit of side spin with the finishing forehand. I start to think to myself, it's easier said than done. Almost nothing has bothered Sofia Polkanova.
But
right back to the middle, stable and quick with the high racket. With play like this, Sofia is going to be very tough to stop. Few holes in her game. This is what makes table tennis so good to watch at the top level. 14 of the last 16 points for Sofia Polkanova. Edge of the racket here. I think they're about even now. They will switch sides of the table as one player has reached five, the halfway mark, or the decided halfway mark. In game number five, the decider. Checking the lights on the new side, ready for the serve. Adriana Diaz still within striking distance. And strike she does, sets it up well with the serve. I've watched Adriana play all around the world, from Chinese Super League to the Indian League to the United States, although she hasn't played league yet. That fast, long serve to extend the lead back. What I was gonna say about Adriana Diaz is her pendulum serve, while it's the most classic serve in the game, has fooled many opponents. Nice big attack on the forehand. Fine balance there in the game of hot potato to see who would take the opening first. And a long push invites it. It's a ticking time bomb. Oh, Diaz.
4-7.
If she wins the point in this rally, jaws dropped everywhere watching this, that she could chase it down. Seemed like maybe even an edge ball still brings it back. The feeling. The defensive shot barely missing the edge. Big point here, second towel break. Sofia Polkanova up by 4, 3 points away from the finish line. The pendulum there perfectly received. Is able to close the racket just enough to push it back low to the net. Not easy to push a topspin serve.
8-5.
Still hope here. For the pride of Puerto Rico within three, keeping the hand cool. And the control center, the brain as well. That serve is just too good. As fast as can be to the baseline. And the net on the way over, hence the apology. Good length in the touch game receive. It's Sofia Polkanova now with 5 match points. They're coming back from 1-2 down. Rocket 10, backhand. Dion's still alive. Fighting spirit still a ways to go. Serves with Polkanova. 4 match points left. And she takes it, a big win. Sofia Polkanova over the world ranked number 9 has eliminated the pride of Puerto Rico.